Here's where to find every character's ultimate weapon in Super Mario RPG. First, let's start with Mario, as his is the earliest weapon you can acquire, as well as the most complicated to find. Now, as you make your way to Nimbus Land, you'll need to get through Bean Valley. At the end will be a boss battle with an overgrown piranha plant called Smilex. Shortly after that battle, the flying shy guy here named Bizo will drop a letter that will contain a seed. Now keep that in mind as you continue on with the game as you normally would. Then, after you've defeated the dastardly Queen Valentina and her henchman Dodo, exit the castle and head to the northeast side of this area. You'll discover that you can oddly walk on air right around here. Out in the open air, you'll find Bizo again, who will give you the fertilizer for the seed if you let him go. So you got the seed and some fertilizer. Well, what do you do with them? Well, now you need to return to Rose Town and head down the pathway to the upper right. Go inside the house and talk to the gardener inside, who has a whole fast-talking bit that he needs to get through. It's very funny. After giving him the seed and the fertilizer, a giant beanstalk will grow out of the pot here. Jump on it to climb it, and up here you'll find two chests. One of them will contain Mario's best weapon, the Lazy Shell. The other will contain the Lazy Shell, but that one's a strong piece of armor that increases defense but lowers offense. It's a good idea to equip that on either Mallow or Peach, as they'll likely be your healer characters and you'll probably want them to stay alive. Now on to the rest of the ultimate weapons, which you'll find fairly close to the end of the game. After you've retrieved Star Piece number 6 and have taken the Nimbus Land bus back to Bowser's Keep, you'll eventually reach a room with 6 doors. Behind them will be either one of 2 action courses, one of 2 battle courses, or one of 2 puzzle courses. Now, unfortunately, what's behind each door is randomized, which can make getting all the best weapons rather annoying. Mallow's ultimate weapon is at the end of one of the action courses. It'll be the one that starts out with this random cliff where you'll need to jump onto these moving platforms over lava. In the next room, you'll need to jump on this ball and move it all the way to the end to reach a higher platform and get through a red door. The last part of this course involves a set of platforms where one platform will rotate around the one in the middle that you're standing on. Reach the very end of this course and you'll be rewarded with Mallow's ultimate weapon, the Sonic Cymbals. Next up is Geno's weapon. To get this, you need to get through a battle course. In these, as you go through the rooms, a Magic Koopa will make progressively more difficult enemies appear to fight you. Just reach the very end of the battle course, and if you wind up fighting this chest enemy at the end called a come on, I guess, then your reward for beating this room will be Geno's ultimate weapon, the Star Gun. Then there's Bowser's ultimate weapon, which you get pretty much the exact same way as Geno's. Just finish the other battle course, and at the end, you'll get Bowser's best weapon, the Drill Claw. Now, as for Peach's ultimate weapon, sometime after you've retrieved the 6-star piece from the Axum Rangers, return to Moleville and head inside the item shop. In there is a toad that sells random junk that he's found. The junk here is actually very rare items that you may find useful. Now, you'll need to buy every single one of these pieces of junk from the toad until you get to the 4th item, a metal plate. Now, that seems rather worthless, doesn't it? Well, that's Peach's ultimate weapon, the frying pan. That's right. Mario gets a giant shell, Geno gets a gun that fires freaking stars, but Peach, she gets a frying pan. Well, at least it makes a funny splat noise when you use it. You know what? That actually sounds pretty painful. I take it all back. That is a good weapon. For more Super Mario RPG news and guides, check out thegamer.com. I'm Jamie Latour, and we'll see you next time.